Okay, you're into the Module 3 lab activity, and if you kind of followed the links, you probably wound up at this Motions of the Sun or Path of the Sun simulator. I know that the student guide has you go through the sidereal time and signs of the zodiac and that sort of stuff. I'm going to skip that. We're going to go straight to the Path of the Sun simulator. And when you pop up the Path of the Sun simulator, it's going to show you this screen. And if you watch the Solar Motion Demonstrator video, you should notice that really what we have here is a simulation that is very similar to the Solar Motion Demonstrator. Let me just show you some of the features and the information we have here. Notice that we are set in Lincoln, Nebraska at latitude 40.8 degrees north, and the time is right about noontime, and what we have in this down here is the sun's altitude and the sun's azimuth. Again, those terms should be pretty familiar with you. The altitude is how far above the horizon, so it's telling me that the sun is 50.9 degrees above the horizon, and the azimuth is how far, which horizon, right? So how far from due north. Remember, due north is 0 degrees, east is 90 degrees, south is 180, so sure enough my azimuth is showing 178.2, pretty close to 180 degrees. So that's showing me that the sun is currently in my southern sky, and pretty high in the sky, 50 degrees above the horizon. Again, that's not surprising. It's noontime. Date of the year is showing you March 24th. Okay, so that shows you the information about the sun. Notice also it gives us the sun's right ascension and the sun's declination. And in fact, I'm going to go ahead and start the animation real quick just advance it for a few hours to show you that the altitude and azimuth change. In fact, notice now my altitude is 34 degrees, meaning 34 degrees above my horizon, and now the horizon that I'm talking about is 237, which is in the southwest. So when you have altitude and azimuth, those are going to change as the day goes on, because the sun's position with respect to an observer changes, and therefore those are wildly fluctuating. But keep an eye on the right ascension and declination values. During the course of the day, the sun's right ascension and declination does not really change. Is kind of fixed in the celestial sphere, so that they don't change remarkably during the course of a particular day. Some other controls that you have. Of course, you can change the latitude if you want to change where your observer is. You can just use a slider, or you can enter the information. So if I wanted to choose Fulton, Mississippi, 34 degrees north, I can try to slide to it, or I can just enter it directly. Now, you can also change the time of the year, the date, by using the slider. And you can also change the time of the day, and you might type the time in, or you can actually kind of wind the clock around. And that's actually, for me, you can either hit the start animation, in which case you can change how quickly the thing animates, or you can actually just wind it around and watch the sun move through the sky. Now you'll notice there's a bunch of different bands on the celestial sphere, and you can actually show those labels. The yellow line is the sun's daily path. Okay, that's what's called a declination line. So right now I'm in June 21st, and the sun's declination is 23 degrees north. That means it's 23 degrees above the celestial equator. And the yellow line is the path the sun is going to take through the sky on that particular day. And that's due to the Earth's rotation. The sun essentially is stationary with respect to the background stars, but it will move through our sky, just like the background stars do, because of the Earth's rotation. That's what the yellow line indicates. The white line is the sun's annual path. So during the course of a day, the sun really doesn't appear to move with respect to the background stars. However, during the course of weeks, months, and certainly during a full year, the sun does move with respect to the background stars. I'm going to show that a little more clearly in another video about the signs of the zodiac. But yes, because the sun is very close to us, the Earth's orbit around the sun makes the sun appear to move with respect to the background stars. So that's what this white line indicates. That's the ecliptic. That's the sun's annual path. And of course, its path during the course of the year is due to the orbit of the Earth around the sun during the course of a year. Okay, now let's just get back into some of the information you'll need to pick off of this thing. So let's take it to we're in approximately Fulton, but I'll make it 34 degrees north. And let's make our time of the year, oh gosh, I'm recording this in mid-September, so September 17th. So we're going to check out very similar to what I did with the solar motion demonstrator earlier. You know, where did the sun rise this morning? Well, I can work back in time and watch that sun, right? This is, you know, wee morning hours, you know, 3 in the morning, 4 in the morning, I can't see the sun. Sun's below my horizon. Now all of a sudden, it rose. And notice it rose almost due east. Climbs in the sky, climbs high in my southern sky. It is not directly overhead, but in order to see it at noontime, I would have to look to the south. I'd have to look 57 degrees above the horizon to see it. And then I take it into the afternoon, and it moves into my western sky and sets almost due west. Now that's on September 17th. You can play around with the different times of the year and figure out where did the sun rise and set on a particular date. Now notice the amount of time. We're right around the autumnal equinox, and notice that the amount of time that the sun spends above my horizon is almost equal to the amount of time that the sun spends below my horizon in Fulton in mid-September as we approach the autumnal equinox, because that's what equinox means, equal night. The sun spends about as much time above the horizon as it does below it. Day is just about as equal, about 12 hours. Night is about 12 hours. Now you'll notice as you change the time of the year, if I move it to June toward the summer solstice and I start my animation, notice that the sun is kind of on a different path. At that point of the year, it's at a different declination. Its declination is about 23 degrees north of the equator, of the celestial equator. And notice what the sun does. It rises north, well north of east, climbs high in my sky. I'll take it around again here. So it rises north of east, climbs high into my southern sky. Again, not directly overhead, but about 80 degrees above my horizon. And then it sets well north of west. And see how much time it spends above the horizon. You can watch it on the clock, compared to the amount of time it spends below the horizon. So days are much longer on June 21st, or late June, than the nights are, which is hopefully a pretty common experience. And again, the cool thing about the simulator is you can change your location, and that's what you really need to do to answer the questions in the lab quiz, is get familiar enough with this simulation that you can change the latitude, change the time of year, and figure out where the sun should be rising, where it should be setting, how high in the sky the sun should be getting, when and where is it directly overhead. Does it ever get directly overhead in Fulton, Mississippi? If I leave my latitude alone and let me move my time to noontime, because that's when the sun is highest in the sky, notice I can change the time of the date of the year. Does the sun ever get to altitude 90 degrees? No way. I'm outside of the tropics. The sun will never get directly overhead at my current location. So play around with these tools, and hopefully you'll be able to have some success with the lab activity. Like I said, do also check out the solar motion demonstrator video that I made, and I'm going to also make another video about the signs of the zodiac, where I'll kind of show you some of the signs of the zodiac that I've got posted up in my classroom. Anyway, hope this helps. Send me some feedback if these are helping or not being very helpful, but good luck with the lab activity.